to another video, and in today's video I'm going to show you the safest and cleanest way to remove your carpet and your tack strips along with your carpet padding. For this project, once this carpet's removed, it's going to get a glue down carpet tile. I'll be doing a video on that later on as well. If you have any questions on how to do that, please look for that video on how to do the glue, what kind of glue, and how you go about laying the tile, the carpet tile. So, for this video, you're going to need a few things. So, I prefer some gloves, just because carpet's dirty, carpet pad's dirty. You don't know if they had pets before, or really what you're going to find when you pull it up. There's concrete floor under this. It's not a plywood. It's not sheeting. So it might be a little bit easier to clean up, actually. So again, what we're going to need is we're going to need a big black construction garbage bag. We're probably actually going to go through two or three of them on this one right here, but you're going to need one just to get you started. You're going to need a cat's paw or a flat bar. You're going to need some kind of hammer. And of course, your utility knife. Okay, so move those out of the way. And to get started, this room, just so you know, it's probably right about 12 by 10, 12 feet wide, 10 feet deep. So for this video, I'm only going to cut up half. It'll make it easier for the video. I'll be able to explain it better, and you'll be able to see why I do that. If I were to cut it into big sections, it would get really heavy, and it would be harder to move at that point. So, we're going to go ahead, and we're going to start cutting our carpet. Like I said, it's about 10 feet this way. So I'm going to find about the middle of the carpet. Don't have to measure it, just eyeball it, where you think the middle is. And you're going to go ahead, and you're going to take your knife, you're going to cut into the carpet, and you're going to cut all the way down, the length of your carpet. So that's what we're going to do first. Here we go. Okay. Now, once you've made that cut, depending on how sharp your knife is, you might have got all the way through, you might not have. Looks like we did. So, go ahead and we'll pull that loose for a second. So now that the carpet's loose, we will go ahead, put our knife away for a minute. And like I told you in the video just a minute ago, I'm gonna cut this in half, just to make it easier. So, same thing this way. So, now what we're going to go ahead and do, we're going to just gently pull it loose around the tack strip. You don't have to yank on it really hard, and you don't really want to. It's just going to get all that dust and that dirt or old pet hair up in the air. Then it's no fun to breathe. So, now that we got that little bit loose, we will go ahead and we'll roll this up. And you don't want to roll it super, super tight. You want to let it be a little bit loose. So you end up with a nice size hole down the middle of it. Explain why in just a minute. So, now that we got that done, let's open up our bag. And no need to pick this up. What you'll do is, you'll go to one end, get the opening of your bag, just lift the one end up, and place it in there. Now you can shimmy your bag over the rest of it. There you go. There you have that part. we'll set this aside for a sec. Now, we have the carpet pad. Now this is gonna be the same thing. If your knife was super sharp, you might have been able to cut all the way through it. Looks like for ours, we got pretty far, it looks like. Yeah. So, we'll go ahead and peel it up. This way didn't cut it so well. So, let's go ahead and we'll cut it some more. Or, if your knife isn't wanting to work, in this case I got a concrete floor, it's kind of just dulling my blade. You can just take your hands and just kind of pull that cut apart. Again, it doesn't hurt to wear the gloves. So, same thing. Just kind of pull this thing loose. There you go. And same idea. Don't shake it loose. Let all the stuff stay inside of it. Go ahead and roll it up. Now, same thing with the bag. Go ahead. We'll stick it in the bag. Nice and clean so far. I like this. Okay, so now you have your tack strip. You want to be careful with your tack strip. And the reason is because it's sharp. So, your best bet is to take your flat bar or your cat's paw. Lately, I've really been into the cat's paw. Don't know why, but typically I do this with my flat bar. But I've been using my cat's paw a lot lately. I'm going to go ahead and use it on this. So, let me tear up a little piece right here, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Closer so you guys can see it. So here's your tack strip. Now, it's obviously got the sharp side on the side that was up, and on the back side, not sure if you can tell, but see you got these longer nails, and those are just like a concrete nail, and they just tacked them right on into the concrete. So that's what you're trying to pull out. With your cat's paw or your pry bar, the way it sits is this way. You take it and you'll go ahead and you will angle it down where your nails are, because you can see them from the top here. You can see the big nail heads. Those are the only ones that you got to worry about. And you'll take your bar and you'll go ahead and start it right under it. Pound it down with your hammer and you'll use it as some leverage and pry it right up. Usually these come out pretty easy. So, let's go ahead. We'll keep going around this way, and I'll show you what you do with these. Would have been nice if I would have worn knee pads. Another one. There you go. For the sake of this video, I won't bore you in going all the way around and doing the whole entire thing. You get the idea by what I'm doing here. I'll put on an after picture so you can see what it looks like when it's done. But even then, it's just a bare empty room. You're not going to really be able to tell a whole lot at that point. So, now that we have our tack strips, our huge pile of tack strips from this giant room we have down here. Here you go. So, back to our bag. Remember I told you, you want to leave this hole down the middle of your trusty carpet, because guess what? It's where your tack strips go. Then that way, they don't cut open your bag. They don't hurt you when you try to throw away your bags. It's just safer. Safer practice. Cleaner, easier. It's the way to do it. All right. Hopefully you guys like this video. I'm going to get to the rest of this room. I got to finish it. And I'll catch you guys on the next one.